Hey everyone, right now I'm going to show you Adobe's new AI application, Firefly. So we're going to look at what it can do, we'll discuss it, and then we'll look at kind of where Adobe's going with this in the future. Now we can see on the homepage there's some different things coming up, but what we want to focus on is the two that are live right now, text to image and text effects. So why don't we start with the text to image, and this is image based generation. We can click here and we can see the gallery. You're going to see a lot of different kind of things that are in here. But it's as simple as typing in something we want to see. So why don't we type in close up of a bee on a flower? And it will generate images based on the text that you give it. So one of the biggest criticisms about AI image generation is using copyrighted material, whereas things like DALL-E, Midjourney, Stable Diffusion just use all the photos which are available on the internet. And a lot of these images, of course, are copyrighted or belong to other people. Adobe is sourcing all of their images from within Adobe Stock. So these are all images that Adobe has licensed. And then what they're going to be doing is figuring out a way to do some revenue share with the contributors to Adobe Stock so that the people that are actually contributing the images are going to get properly compensated. So this is a lot easier to use than Midjourney because we can simply just click on things, whereas in Midjourney you have to actually put the text prompt in there. And this is the close-up of the bee. I want it highly detailed. I want to do a bokeh, macro, photorealistic, and this is what we get. Now, at this point, I think the images of Midjourney are actually a little bit better than what we're getting in Firefly at the moment, but let's move ahead and see what we can do here. So we have the ability to choose photo. So we can choose a content type, a graphic, art, or photo. We're going to do a photo in this case, and it's going to regenerate the four images. Now, before I show you what you can do with these images, let's go through and set all the parameters. So we've got different styles and different things that we can scroll down and we can look at these one at a time, styles, movements, themes, or we can simply just choose all and all of those will open at once, or we can click them one at a time. So movement is the style. So, you know, it could be a steampunk, sci-fi, or is a particular style you're looking for, cyberpunk. You know, if we want to do a cyberpunk one, it could be kind of interesting and you just hit generate. So we could choose themes. And as you can see, you know, we can do stamp, we can do different types of things. Let's choose hyper-realistic. We're going to choose techniques. And we're not going to choose any of these techniques because we're going for a realistic looking photo. Let's choose effects. We definitely want a bokeh because we want to get nice and close. And let's choose the materials. So you can see the materials you can have in here. Concepts. And so you could do a lot of different things. Let's look at the color and tone. In this case, we're just going to leave it at the default. Lighting. Let's do a dramatic lighting. And in composition, why don't we do a close-up? And notice as we are creating these, they all get added in here. So now we can choose generate, and it will take these attributes and generate these images again. Okay, definitely looking better. And if we want to regenerate them, we can just hit refresh, or we can find the one that we like the best, like say maybe this one here, and then we can click show similar, and this will create similar results to this particular one. So you see we got different options, and if you want to download it, we just simply hit download here, and this will download it, but what it's going to do is it's going to put a watermark on it, and also add content credentials saying that this image has been created by AI. So let's just hit continue. And this is the image you're going to get. You'll get this little watermark in the corner. And the images at this point are not for commercial use. It's just for testing it out. And once this is released, you can use it commercially. But it'll be released in different ways. But I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Let's try something else. Let's clear the styles, and I'm going to do something different. Let's do a person. Okay, let's put in something a little bit more complicated. And we can see here we're starting to get some pretty cool looking results. Now, this is where we could go a little bit more wild. Let's go with the photo again. I'm just going to click on all, and we're going to choose steampunk. And we're going to choose fantasy. Notice some of these we're able to drop more than one. We're going to make this concept art, digital art, and why don't we just generate from that? All right, these are kind of cool. And so you can click on it and view them nice and large. So you can click on each one here to preview them. You know, and if you want to modify it, we can just simply click away and change something in here. Let's do cubic and see if this changes it to more of a cube. Yep, at least one of them got it. Let's get some palm trees going. And let's maybe we'll get more than one airship. All right, we're getting some interesting looking results here. So just in comparison, I'm going to grab all this and we're going to try the same thing in Midjourney. In Midjourney, we have to type in imagine as the prompt, and then I'm just going to paste all of these in, and we have to, let's make it photorealistic, highly detailed. So you have to type these into the description in Midjourney. You can't just click the buttons like you can in Firefly. And for those of you who don't know, I've done a video before on Midjourney. Midjourney is kind of like the leader right now in the AI generation. And we can compare some images, you know, maybe some cute cats. All right, let's have a look at the other option here, which is text effects. So let's have a look at the text effects. And what I'm going to do here is I want to tell the letter I want to do is PSC. Let's do Photoshop Cafe. So we're going to do PSC, and why don't we just do zebra? All right, that's kind of interesting. A little bit more zebra's heads in here than I was kind of expecting, but those are kind of cool. Now you get variations. You get four variations that you can click on and examine these. And at any time you can hit refresh and generate four more. But let's add something to this. Let's do zebra red and yellow and see what happens. And you can see it does that. But there's other things that we can add in here. Why don't we make it furry? All right, that's kind of interesting. And now you have the ability here to do tight, loose, or medium. Let's try a looser. It might let the fur kind of breathe a little bit more. Definitely does. And of course, you know, we can choose the fonts. Right now we've got a background here, which is clear. We can add a colored background if we want. We can also change the text color, but in this case, we're not doing a colored text. So the color is not really going to do anything at the moment because we're using this texture. Let's try that one there. It looks kind of interesting. All right, that's interesting. And if we look at the fonts, it doesn't give us a ton of fonts, but we've got a few fonts here that we can choose from. Let's try something else here. Let's change this from furry to leafy. That's interesting. Now let's see what happens if we take the red and yellow away, and we're just going to go with the zebra leafy. All right, that's very cool and interesting. Let's go with the first option, and I'm going to go for medium fit. And I'm going to take the background color, and we're going to go back to transparent. Well, that's pretty cool. Now, if you want to use this, what you can do is we roll over here and we can download this, and we can download it with the transparency. We'll just hit continue. And I'm just going to drag this into Photoshop. And here we have it on a transparent layer. So this is the kind of thing you could start to use to build out some interesting things. I'm going to discuss how Adobe's going to be using it and how I think it's going to be used. Okay, so Firefly is basically a beta. It's an experiment to just kind of get this image generation going. But Adobe has plans to build this into their software to do different things. And let's examine some of the things that Adobe's proposing. So one of them, it looks here, this looks like Photoshop on the iPad. But we could see this kind of coming to Photoshop where they can, you know, generate different parts of an image here. And then the other thing they could do is make selections over parts of the image and regenerate those different parts. So that's one thing you're doing. The other one, you know, working with artwork inside of Illustrator, this looks like. You know, being able to take a picture of something that you draw, bring it in, and generate a vector out of that and modify that vector. That looks kind of cool. Then here's one that looks really interesting, is doing video and being able to have different effects on the video. So, you know, starting with a video of something, changing the scene to winter is what it's doing here. And we've already seen, I've seen some music videos where we've got the AI video generation. So this is something that, you know, could come to Premiere Pro or After Effects, something like this to kind of help. And it's a little bit like some of the neural filters in Photoshop that we're already seeing on images, but this looks like it would be in video. Then when it comes to things like marketing, social media is what it says here, but basically layout. So we can have, you know, like AI help us to create layouts and templates and different things like that, designing for us. And then we go down here, what they're talking about doing with 3D is being able to just drop things onto a 3D model. And of course, you know, we're going to be using photogrammetry in the future where we can just take photos of things and those are going to be converted into AI models of 3D models. And then being able to, you know, just drop different materials and textures and stuff like that on here. This is our first look into Adobe Firefly, which is Adobe's latest AI. Now, if you want to know my thoughts about how I think AI is going to affect creators, artists, photographers in the future, how's it going to affect our jobs, how's the AI age going to affect all of us, I had a discussion on this video right here where I give you all my thoughts and a little bit of the history of technology. So check that out. And let me know your comments under here. What do you guys think about Firefly and AI? Just drop a comment. And as always, like and subscribe, turn on notifications. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.